And good morning to you on this Sunday. I'm Lynn Smith, and thank you for spending part of your day with us here on Weekend Express. And we do begin this morning with the president-elect, Donald Trump. He has more words for U.S. Representative John Lewis, who says he questions the legitimacy of Trump's presidency. And we're going to have more on the clash between the president-elect and Congressman Lewis in just a moment. But first, Mexico says it will retaliate if President-elect Donald Trump keeps his promise of placing a border tax on companies doing business in that country. Now, Trump has threatened to hit manufacturers who yesterday, her birth parents traveled to South Carolina to meet Kamaya. Her father says he never gave up hope and urged other parents of missing children not to give up. Successful launch and return for a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket. Watch. Welcome back. So before we get too far into the new year, this is a great time to review your expenses, maybe do a deep budget cleanse. So earlier I talked to Oxygen Financial's Ted Jenkin about how to save some money and some other money-saving ideas you might consider for 2017.
Well, Ted, no one's going to fight you on wanting to save money. But let's start with something that we can cut that won't hurt in the new year.
Well, this is the time of year that you get your year-end credit card statement. So you should go through it and try to figure out what was a recurring...
On groceries, we have to eat. But you say there are ways to save money when you're grocery shopping.
Well,
just happen to pick up a few more things every time you go. I do that. You also say that a lot of people are cutting the cord on their landline. And there are other ways that they can save on phone and cable.
Well, this is...
And you got to wonder, why aren't they calling me as a customer to offer me these deals, right? So it's the holidays, so you probably have racked up some gift cards, maybe some frequent flyer miles. What should people do with those?
Well, you're going to be planning out your family vacations now, so it's going to be important that you...
Reason to spend money. You say look at your insurance, your car insurance, your home insurance. How could you reevaluate that?
Well, save some dollars in that insurance policy and cleanse your budget out for 2017.
So maybe a little extra work, but the end result is extra cash.
It's like $290 extra money.
Exactly. Well, ice on the highways is making travel treacherous in several states. So ahead, we're going to check in whether or not better weather is on the way today. Plus this. Good morning to you on this Sunday. It's half past the hour. I'm Lynn Smith, and welcome back to Weekend Express. The big story today is the reaction to the president-elect's tweets about Congressman John Lewis. But first things first, police have arrested a homeless man suspected of setting fire to a mosque in Washington State. Now, they say he has had run-ins with worshipers there before, but there's no evidence of a hate crime, they say. No one was injured, and the suspect is expected to be charged with second-degree arson on Tuesday. It is being called the Hearing Protection Act, but opponents in Congress say the bill will actually make it easier to buy a gun silencer. Republicans introduced the proposal this week, and it would still require a background check to buy a device to muffle the sound of a gunshot, but a $200 fee and a long waiting period would be eliminated. Turkey and Russia have agreed to invite the U.S. to the next round of Syrian peace talks. Those are scheduled just 3 days after Friday's inauguration. It is unclear if the Trump administration will accept the invitation. President, back everyone. So are mammogram screenings leading to overdiagnosis and unnecessary cancer treatments? Well, there is a new study suggesting that early diagnosis has not helped cut down the number of advanced cases of breast cancer. I know I certainly got your attention with this. OBGYN Sujatha Reddy is here to break down this study for us, because I'm very hesitant and always very cautious when we discuss things like this, because I sit here all the time saying early detection studies have found are the only thing we have. So who did this study and what did it find exactly?
And you're right. I think we have to emphasize recommendations, but still, mammograms are good. We just need to, now we still treat them all the same.
And bottom line, regardless of the study, you have not changed your recommendations for your patients.
I have not. I still recommend.
To a different topic of vaccines. And it's a topic because this week, President-elect Trump met with a vaccine skeptic, Robert Kennedy Jr., and that raised a lot of eyebrows in the medical community. It'd be a concern for people.
Yeah, I think this has been brought up and it deserves to be retold this week. I'm a firm believer in vaccines. They save lives.
Well, and as a new mom, everyone does a ton of research and even spreading out vaccines. How do you react to that when it comes to patients, real quick?
If you can make sure, no data that says that's harmful, but if you feel better spreading it out, that's okay, as long as you make sure your child gets the entire schedule.
Dr. Sujatha Reddy, always good information. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.